The residents at St. Celia's do not have fond memories of the past year. COVID ripped through their care home last April and many lost friends. All of them have now been vaccinated, along with nearly all of the staff here. But forcing those who haven't is not something the owner wants to do.
In any one day, there's been 120,000 vacancies. We want to welcome people in social care. We don't want a barrier about the vaccination issue. But I'm also worried about the fact that the staff we've already got, if they refuse, the government's saying if you can't redeploy them, they might have to lose their job. And I don't think that's the right approach.
In England, there are more than 473,000 staff working in older adult care eligible for the vaccine. But as of the 10th of June, nationally, nearly 77,000 hadn't had one dose yet. That's 16% of staff. It's why the government's decided to take a tough approach.
The vast majority of staff in care homes are already vaccinated, but not all. And we know that the vaccine not only protects you, but protects those around you. And therefore, we will be taking forward the measures to ensure the mandation for as a condition of deployment for staff in care homes.
They will now have 16 weeks to comply with the new law, but some residents feel there's still time to try and persuade their carers.
You do feel better. Well, I feel safer being injected.
It's up to them because it's their body. But if somebody can tell them that it's to their benefit, I think that shady area, they could think, well, it's not going to do me harm.
A consultation on whether both COVID and flu vaccines should be compulsory for all NHS workers will now take place. Today's decision is an unprecedented move, but for the government, a necessary one. Emily Morgan, News at 10.